Hey everybody, today we are going to be talking about the Motor Trend leaving YouTube and starting their own stuff on their own website. So if you don't know what Motor Trend is a channel here on YouTube or an organization that is dedicated to cars and car stuff in general. If you've ever heard of Head to Head, Roadkill, Ignition, Engine Masters, then you know what I'm talking about. Their YouTube channel has around 5.6 million subscribers. Earlier this week, they announced that they're going to be moving all of their stuff off from YouTube and onto their own platform, MotorTrend.com. You're still going to be able to watch their shows for free with ads for 8 weeks on MotorTrend.com, and then you can subscribe to an ad-free service for $4.99 a month, and you get some more perks and all that mumbo jumbo. That doesn't mean that they're deleting their YouTube channel. But basically, all of the stuff you know Motor Trend for on YouTube is no longer going to be on their YouTube channel, and you're going to have to go to their website instead. This does not surprise me at all due to the fact that YouTube's ad revenue has never really recovered after the Adpocalypse 1 and 2 and 3, right? It makes sense that Motor Trend would leave YouTube and go to its own website. That way, the whole thinking here is this, since YouTube ad revenue is already, it's already as bad as it is, and YouTube already takes a cut of that for themselves, hashtag Google, right? Motor Trend's thinking here is that by having their videos on their own website, they can in fact get all revenue 100% for themselves. Which is, yeah, it makes sense, right? It's a good idea. You don't have to share revenue with YouTube at all. Our problem is, I guarantee you the 5.6 million subscribers is not gonna transfer over to MotorTrend.com, I guarantee you. How many people are going to go watch them on MotorTrend.com? I don't know, but I sure as hell bet you it isn't going to be the 5.6 million subscribers they got right now. Now, one of the hosts of the show, David Freiberger, Roadkill, he co-hosts with Finnegan on that show. Great show, by the way. As you react to the news, please separate your feelings about company decisions from your comments about our host. Personally, I'm sad that Roadkill will no longer be available to use who cannot afford a subscription, especially the kids if we've started to become car people. However, we as hosts and producers still love what we do, and we are lucky to do it, and want to continue making great shows. The best message you can do is to keep the original Motor Trend shows on top by continuing to watch on MotorTrend.com, even if you can do it for free. Now, another issue I have is Motor Trend's parent company, the Enthusiast Network, got bought by Discovery last fall, and I'm kind of worried about what they're going to be doing to Motor Trend and Motor Trend shows, if they're going to get their grimy paws on that and screw it up. Hopefully they don't. Yeah, they're being bought out by a big corporation, right? And if you remember back when Motor Trend and Roadkill did a battle between the Gas Monkey Garage guys and the Roadkill fellows, they basically ended up getting cucked, basically, by Gas Monkey Garage and Discovery. I think Discovery owns GM. I think they own them. But the whole thing was, we couldn't watch the drag race that they hyped up for weeks because due to issues legally. So they couldn't even tell us who won the race. We had to go to Discovery and pay for the video. And Freiberger got kind of mad about that. He was like, that's why we like being online here. We don't have anyone telling us what to do from like Discovery, blah, 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 yada, yada, yada. And now they're bought out by Discovery, right? So, kind of interesting to see how that turned out all in the end. Not sure if Discovery owns Gas Monkey Garage, by the way. Don't quote me on that. I'm just saying, I think it is. If it's not, please enlighten me. The quality of video they put out is really good, really high production stuff. And a lot of high production stuff costs high production money. So it doesn't surprise me that they're not making enough money, not enough return on YouTube to keep funding themselves. But like I say, it's like putting a Hollywood production into a indie film that's not going to be viewed by a lot of people. There's no point in doing that, right? So if I was them, I would cut back on costs, maybe don't bring as many vans, scale down your equipment, maybe use your phones, maybe like cheap lapel mics and stuff. Basically cut down on the excess and stuff and make it more affordable for you guys as a corporation, as a program, as an organization, so you guys don't have to be taking cuts and stuff. And by taking cuts, like, I mean, taking all your shit off YouTube. So yeah, I think that could have helped Motor Trend also not being so high quality stuff. But that's one of the main appeals of Motor Trend, that it's so high quality, right? So it's kind of like a double-edged sword. It's me saying that. that's been a big issue now on YouTube with the card channels, especially when they try to do something big. If you guys remember, Super Speeders Rob, aka Rob Freddy, Rob Spaghetti, he did a Project Card Challenge a couple months ago, and it was almost canceled because he couldn't find any sponsors to sponsor his challenge. And a lot of people are like, oh, blah, 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 blah. He's just making excuses. He's rich as fuck, blah, 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 blah. He just wants free money, blah. I don't know how rich Rob Freddy is. I honestly don't, but stuff costs money. And when stuff costs money, you can't just be like, hey, look, I'm going to go outside to that tree over there and pull down a couple hundred bills, right? And I'm going to fund this program. It just doesn't work like that. So people have high expectations of content creators. They want the best of the best of the best for free. And then they start bitching when they don't get it for free. They're like, ah, blah, 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 blah. You guys are assholes, blah, rich ass, blah, greedy motherfuckers. Hey, you'd be doing the exact same goddamn thing if you were in Rob's position or Motor Trend's position also. So yeah, Motor Trend leaving YouTube. Don't surprise me. Ad revenue, it's always been bad on YouTube for these last years. It never really bounced back from the apocalypse. What I find funny is that the whole reason why smaller channels got demonetized like me is because the bigger channels deserved more ads, and so by cutting us out, bigger channels could get more ads, right? Okay, yeah. It looks like that worked perfectly fine for Motor Trend. They got all the ads they needed. But it's sad to see Motor Trend go off from YouTube, but it's only natural. YouTube as a platform is very negative, very bad, and it's getting worse by the day. There's no accountability on YouTube's part. There's no transparency on YouTube's part. They do stuff, they don't tell us, or when they do stuff, they hide it in their website in some godforsaken forum or board, whatever they have on there. And then it's up to us to find out what the hell's going on. YouTube always ignores the early signs of an issue. Case in point, the whole ElsaGate thing, they knew about it. They didn't do anything about it till it was too late in big national headline news, right? But yeah, me ranting on YouTube, that's a whole nother video that I want to make. But yeah, I've already ranted a little bit too much on this. Let me just sum it up real quick here. Motor Trend leaving YouTube is sad. And it also sets a precedent here that we cannot expect high quality content like Motor Trend's shows anymore to be popping up on YouTube as much. It's going to be significantly harder and harder for creators to bring out content like that without asking for a subscription from people or asking for a donation or putting it behind a paywall. The ad revenue will not fund these shows anymore. The heyday of YouTube is long gone and is over. This is like the silver age of YouTube, right? So as the years go on, expect more people to be pushing their Patreons, which is fine. There's nothing wrong with that. Their Patreons, their own websites, their own merch even more sponsorships. It's going to be happening a lot more, guys. And that's just sadly the situation of YouTube. If YouTube had a backbone and actually cared about its creators, this would have never happened. Never. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching the video. What do you guys think of Motor Trend leaving YouTube? Let me know in the comment section down below. I also have a new video coming up pretty soon about the 400Z. About the 400Z. God, I'm still sick. Thanks for watching, everyone. Peace out.